Hi, I'm Steve. You can call me Steve. For the past 2 years, I've been working on SNOW Plus, which is a neutrino experiment located 2 kilometers down Vale's Creighton Mine in Sudbury, Ontario. It's a continuation of the original Sudbury Neutrino Observatory experiment, which is where the acronym SNOW comes from. That experiment won the 2015 Nobel Prize in Physics. Our collaboration consists of over 150 people located in dozens of universities and institutes spread across North America and Europe. I'm going to show you what it is we do here and how we do it. But first, I want to show you what I think is the coolest thing here, my cubicle. If you'd have told me 5 years ago I'd be doing cutting-edge science at one of Canada's premier institutes, I'd never have believed you. SNOW Plus is a 12-meter acrylic sphere filled with liquid scintillator, which is a fancy way of saying it's a giant plastic bubble full of a chemical that flashes when a neutrino hits it. That flash is picked up by the thousands of photodetectors surrounding the sphere that you see here, converted into electrical impulses, and then sent to computers to be processed into meaningful data. The lab is underground because our detector is so sensitive, it sees almost every type of subatomic particle that comes along, including some weird ones from outer space that we don't care about. If we put 2 kilometers of rock over top, it screens out everything except our neutrinos. We're passing through a working mine, which means we have to follow the same safety regulations as the miners. This includes mining boots with a steel guard on it, a miner's belt, and a hard hat with a light on it. The mine is a very dirty place, and before we can come in the door, we have to hose the worst of the mud off our boots and leave them here, along with the hard hats and the belts. All the material that comes into the clean lab has to be cleaned, starting here in the outer car wash. A preliminary cleaning is administered here, and sturdier objects get a pressure washing. On the clean side of the car wash, a final rinse and wipe is administered to ensure everything meets the cleanliness standards of the lab. You can't pressure wash people, so we all have to take showers. Mine dust and other dirt contain very, very small amounts of contaminants, which can cause interference with the experiments down here. Therefore, everybody who comes into the facility, including visitors, must take a shower. I can attest it makes for a very, very awkward job interview. After the shower, everybody wears the same standard issue blue coveralls, plus steel-toed boots to protect our feet from the facility, and a hairnet to protect the facility from us. One of the things people ask most is what it's like underground. Well, it's like this. It's bright, spacious, well-lit. It's easy to quickly forget just how much rock is over your head. The walls are covered with something called shotcrete, which stops them collapsing on us. Now in the lab, we have varying levels of cleanliness. You can go most places on just the shower you took to get in. But if you want to go into our control room, you need to take an air shower. I'm sitting here in the control room where all of the magic happens. This is one of the photodetectors that surround the giant plastic bubble. Thousands more like it will collect all of the flashes of light that happen from neutrino strike. And those flashes of light get turned into signals like this. Now we're standing right above the giant plastic bubble. These are just a tiny fraction of the electronics needed to run the photodetectors. And through here is a clean room around the top of the detector. Now we're already in a clean room, so this is an even cleaner room. The top opening's accessible in there, so we're worried about particulates drifting in and causing contamination. Now unfortunately, the view in there is not that great. So if you want to see the detector up close, you need to go down there. I'm on a boat. The detector sits in this 30-meter cavity, which is filled with water, to act as an extra layer of shielding for any radiation coming out of the rock. It's okay, it's a very low level, it doesn't pose any threat to human health.
We use these little inflatable boats to inspect and maintain anything that needs inspecting and maintaining. This is easily the world's deepest boat ride. Anyway, you're not here to talk about boats. We're here to see the detector.
Seeing it on a screen just doesn't do justice to its grandeur. Being this close to it like this is probably one of the coolest parts about working here.
Before we can fill the giant plastic bubble, everything going into it needs to be purified. We're talking hundreds of thousands of liters of flashy liquid here, which is a bit more than you can deal with on the benchtop. So what we've done is taken a full-sized chemical plant and crammed it into a corner of the mine.
I've spent far too much time crawling around in here. The skilled work was done by contractors, but most of the students and researchers and other people in the collaboration have done at least a few shifts in here, cleaning, turning wrenches, checking for leaks, helping the pipe fitters. It really is a collaborative effort getting this place up and running. All of this is designed to remove the small amount of radioactive atoms found in everything. They don't pose a health hazard, but they'll cause interference in the detector, so they have to come out.